So let us now talk about the repulsive interaction in the case of inert gas crystals. Let us consider two atoms A and B. As the two atoms are brought together, their charge distribution gradually overlap. So there are two atoms. Charge distribution is graphically shown like this. There are two atoms A and B whose charge distribution can be represented by this graph. Okay. So these are the two independent atoms. The circle represents the nucleus, and this graph represents the electron charge density. Okay, as the so this is the center. As we move away from the center, the electron charge distribution density decreases. Now, when they are very close, sufficiently close separation, what happens? This charge distribution may overlap. Okay. This overlap very closely. So due to this, there will be a repulsive force between these two. So at a sufficiently close separation, the overlap energy is repulsive, okay, because of Pauli exclusion principle. This is due to the Pauli exclusion principle. So we have considered two atoms A and atom B. Their charge distribution is shown in this figure. When they are very close to each other, that means they are very close separation, the overlap energy will be repulsive. That means they repel each other due to the Pauli exclusion principle. So how Pauli exclusion principle decides this repulsive force? Because when the charge distribution of the two atoms overlap, there is a tendency of electrons of B to occupy states of A, already occupied by the electrons of A. Okay. So this atom B, the electrons of B, there is a tendency of these electrons to occupy the states of A. It's already occupied by the electrons of A. Okay, and vice versa. So the Pauli exclusion principle prevents this multiple occupancy. Okay, so the Pauli exclusion principle prevent the multiple occupancy of a particular level. Therefore, the charge distribution can overlap only if it is accompanied by a promotion of some of the electrons of B to the unoccupied higher level. Okay. So if this to occupy, so some electrons should go to higher energy level, and this vacancy is occupied by the electrons of B. So that's why the total energy of the system now increases. Okay. So this is a repulsive contribution to the interaction. Okay. So the total energy increases. Total energy of the system increases. Energy increases means a repulsive contribution. Okay. So this repulsion is due to the overlap of energy levels. The empirical repulsive energy is of the form. This energy is of the form V by R raised to 12. So this is obtained by fitting experimental data. B is a constant, positive constant. Okay. So the total potential energy of the two atoms separated by R is U is equal to, this is U, we can write U repulsive. Okay. U is equal to, or U of R is equal to 4 sigma by R raised to 12 minus sigma divided by R raised to 6. Okay, so this is the total energy of two atoms, where epsilon and sigma are new parameters, which are given by 4 epsilon sigma raised to 6, the quantity A, and 4 epsilon sigma raised to 12 is the constant B. Okay. So we have already shown that the interaction, the attractive potential is minus A by R raised to 6, and the repulsive potential is B divided by R raised to 12. So this is the total potential. Okay. Now this potential is called the Lennard-Jones potential. This potential of this form U of R is equal to 4 E sigma by R raised to 12 minus sigma by R raised to 6. This is called Lennard-Jones potential. Okay. So from this we can find out the force, the total force. Therefore the force is equal to minus du by dr or du by dx. So this potential, from this we can find out the, now the cohesive energy of an inert gas crystal is given by, therefore cohesive energy of an inert gas is given by summing all the Lennard potential. So this potential is only between two atoms. There are number of atoms in that. If n number of atoms are there, if n is the total number of atoms, then there will be n by 2 pi s, n by 2 pair of atoms. Therefore the total Lennard potential, the sum of all the Lennard potential between this n by 2 pi s is equal to U total. So this is the total cohesive energy. U total is equal to n by 2 times 4 E sum of sigma by P I J R whole raised to 12. Okay. Sum over all these quantity minus sigma J sigma by P I J R whole raised to 6. So this is the total energy. So where P I J times R is the distance between the reference atom, atom I, and any other atom in terms of the distance R. P I J is a factor. Okay. So it is, for example, R is the nearest neighbor distance. In terms of the nearest neighbor distance, what is the distance of the two atoms, I and J? Okay. So if we sum over all these things, we will get the total energy, that is the cohesive energy in the case of inert gas crystals. Okay. For FCC, we know that most of the inert gas crystal forms in face-centered cubic crystal. So for FCC and HCP, these are the closest packing HCP. This value of sum of Pij whole raised to 12 is equal to 12.13 and sum of 1 by Pij raised to 6 is equal to 14.45. Okay. If we substitute the value in this equation, we'll get the U total. U total is equal to 0. So equilibrium separation between the nearest neighbors is R0. Okay. So we can find out using this expression, du total divided by dr is equal to 0. The potential energy will be minimum. So that is du by dr is equal to 0. So using this 2n epsilon into minus 12 into 12.13 into sigma by sigma raised to 12 r raised to 13 minus, and this will be plus 14.45 into 6 sigma raised to 6 divided by r raised to 7. This is equal to 0. So you can write, okay. So simplifying this, we get 2n goes this side, so it will become 0. 12 into 12.3. So this will be sigma by r raised to sigma divided by sigma raised to 6 r raised to 6 is equal to 6 into 14.45 divided by 12 into 12.13. So this is equal to 4 r by sigma is equal to get this is equal to 1.09. Okay. So this is in agreement with this value is in agreement with the value of r by sigma for all the inert gases.